Converting miniatures to put your own personal stamp on them is one of the most fun parts of collecting Citadel miniatures, and in this video we're going to have a look at how you could convert some Cataphractii Terminators to make them distinctly Space Wolves. Now, Space Wolves have a very distinctive style about them, so what I've got here are some spare parts from a Wolf Guard Terminator set. I've also built my Cataphractii Terminator except for the left arm, which is going to be holding a power sword, also from that Wolf Guard set, and you can see I've got the full assembly still separate, so we can make that. Now, the other parts I've got are all these decorative parts here, things like wolf tails and an eye, that sort of thing, and I've also got a spare head too, which we're going to put in later on. Now, when you're doing converting like this, the most important thing to remember is that these parts aren't actually designed to fit together in this way necessarily, so you need to make sure they fit before you glue anything, so always test fit them. So for example, this little crest which I want to put on top of the Terminator armor, if I could just test that first of all, you can see there's clearly nothing in the way for that fit to work just there, so we can go straight on and glue that on. Now, the kind of glue I'm using for this is plastic glue, and the way this glue works is it actually melts the plastic a little bit and bonds it into one piece, so it gives a very strong join, but because of that it can melt detail, so you must be careful not to put on too much at once. You don't want it to start going on to finer details or anything. So here we go, I'm just going to glue that on there and let it dry. Sometimes, however, parts won't quite have an easy fit. An example of that is when you try and put a head on Cataphractii Terminators with a normal Space Marine head, because the fitting's very different, you see. So what I've had to do with this head here is cut it in half so that it fits in place there. And then once again, it's a good idea to test it to make sure it fits before you glue anything. Just like with the head, for this power sword arm we've had to do a bit of clipping as well to cut it down so the parts fit. So this arm here is normally the one that holds the power sword for the Terminator Sergeant, and I want to add this Wolf Guard sword instead. So what I've had to do is clip away the sword as best I could with my clippers just there, then at the back again keep clipping away and file it down till I've removed all that plastic there. Done the same with the sword here, I just removed a little bit on the back again using my clippers, and with that done it's now ready to fit together. With that power sword assembly made, I've now glued the arm to the rest of our Cataphractii, and the next part I'm going to add is this little wolf tail pendant. Now, I've clipped the ring at the top in half and put some glue on too, so when I put it underneath the combi welter, I get a good fitting. The next part I'm going to add is this little decorative element here hanging on a chain, and this is going to go hanging from the belt just in front here. The last part I'm going to add is this little knife. Now, it's getting quite busy around the front here, so what I'm going to do is attach it just on the back, just here. And here we have the completed Wolf Guard Cataphractii Terminator, and to compare him, I've got another Cataphractii built here without any Space Wolf parts at all, and you can see the one on the left is clearly a Space Wolf. Now, this kind of thing you can, well, dabble in as much as you want, but the really great thing about Space Wolf kits is that every single one has loads of leftover parts just for this kind of thing. So give it a go, and if you do try it, let us know how you get on. We'll see you again very soon.